Yeah, we just learned how we can make our code more reproducible, so let's get to it and use the deterministic setting in Lightning. So here we are reusing the code from unit 5.3 and now make it reproducible. So all the code here is identical to 5.3, which we covered before, except that we are now making a little modification right here to make the data loaders reproducible, as well as the initial model weights of the PyTorch multilayer perceptron here. So what we are seeding here is the random number generator in PyTorch. So we are setting manual seed 1, 2, 3. Which number you use does not matter as long as you use a fixed integer number. And then every time you use that number and run the code again, it should be reproducible. So this manual seed will affect the shuffling order of the datasets, and it will also affect the initial model weights of the PyTorch multilayer perceptron. Then additionally, to use deterministic algorithms, we can also say deterministic equals true here. So let's run this code. So what we get is the following performance. Let's actually put it here somewhere for reference. And then we will run it again. So we'll take a look at these values here, run the code again and see what we get. As we can see, the numbers are exactly the same as before. So now for comparison, let us actually deactivate the deterministic behavior and the random seed and run the code again. And let's see what happens now. So now we see the results are slightly different because we don't have deterministic behavior anymore and no fixed random seed. And if I run this code once more, you should also see that the results are different again. So yeah, you can see the results are slightly different because the dataset shuffling order changed slightly, and we also don't have this deterministic setting now. So if you want to have deterministic behavior, enable this deterministic setting and set a random seed. So yeah, we just saw how we can use the deterministic setting in Lightning to make our code reproducible between runs. Each time you execute this code now, you should get the same results.